I'm a heavyweight.
All right.
Right, now let's start the build-up to the main event of the evening. James Cook against Mark Kaylor, the European super middleweight title. First, Kaylor, perhaps in his twilight years now, and while no longer the fresh athlete of the early 80s, he still has the heart and the courage to cause an upset, and he's determined to prove his critics that he's not finished with boxing yet.
The West Ham boy is back and on home territory and determined to prove that a star middleweight of the 80s can become a champion at super middleweight in the 90s. Kaylor's seen just about everything this game can throw at you here and in the States, and though he's had his share of ring battles, the commitment remains total.
I've been boxing now as a pro for 11 years, you know. It's not hard for me because I love the game. I love boxing, right? So that's where some people might be past it at 30 years of age. I'm not one of them. I'm not finished.
He's a good fighter, James Cook, especially from the way he's come through the ranks. Like, as he, no disrespect to him, but he was always an opponent. But for what he's done, British and European champion, he's even got more respect for doing it the way he's done it. And we're expecting a very hard fight. And all I can say, Mark's prepared for it.
Bare facts detail a career which earned British and Commonwealth middleweight titles, but they don't betray the courage. This will be his sixth major championship fight. Every time, he's given everything.
The tension now almost unbearable. And Kaylor spits out his gum shield. Perfect climax to a major title fight. The pair of them very nearly sold out. All a lot closer than it was earlier.
A close decision against Kaylor. But ever since, he's been reaching out for championships.
Amazingly determined man. You know, he's chopped and changed all around the world. There's no such thing as adversity where he's concerned. You know, he's going to win at all costs. That's Kaylor's, you know, outlook on life.
Nobody doubts, Gary, the courage of Kaylor, but Drayton, Sibson, Graham, Collins and Galvano, all big fights in Kaylor's career. He's lost them all, the big fights.
Those fights have had no hostility. When there's been hostility, i.e. Gums and Christie, he's won those. There's no hostility tonight.
You believe he can do it tonight. Now for Cook. Cook, 32 years of age now, the European champion. A mixed career, you'd have to admit that. 24 fights, 16 victories, but 8 defeats. And even he admits that not too many people had heard of him until he won that European title. Now, all falling into place. Biggest dream is to become the world champion.
The story of James Cook is of patience rewarded. Now aged 32, finally he starts to pick up reward for years of dedication, mostly in the shadow of other big-name fighters. Maybe Cook missed out on opportunities through being too dangerous an opponent for his own good. He certainly spent years of his career at middleweight traveling Europe just to stay busy. He held down a full-time job back home as a youth officer and earned extra cash as a sparring partner for Mark Kaylor.
I expect it to be a hard fight, a tough fight, and I expect Mark to put up the best performance because he's going to think, hey, I used to pay this guy to spar with me. Now I'm giving a crack of my title, so it's going to be a hard, a good fight, and at the end, I'm keeping my title.
It all began falling into place for Cook when he'd stepped up to super middleweight. He'd created one upset, winning the British crown in Belfast, when once more he went travelling, this time to Paris, to fight Pierre-Franc Winterstein for the European title. It was all there from Cook on this night. He proved his courage in the higher weight division, getting up from a ninth round knockdown, and thanks to supreme conditioning, bossed the closing rounds before putting Winterstein away. It went down as an even bigger surprise, but when people began to study the quality of the decisive uppercut, they began to believe what Cook and his handlers had always said, that he could yet become a world champion.
James Cook's a very dedicated man as a fighter. He's a clean living boy. As you know, he works with kids. He's a family man. I've got no worry about when he goes away from the gym, like some, about what discos there might be going on the way. He's just a clean living fighter, dedicated to the game of being a champion. And that's why he's become British champion and European champion.
I've waited so long, I've worked hard. And like I say, at the end of the day, if you say to a person, who is James Cook? I don't even think my next door neighbor knows I do boxing. You know, that's the joy about it. You know, I could do what I want, and this is my title. I work hard for it. There's no way I'm going to give it up just like that.
They're both true professionals, and when they get in and that bell goes, believe me, you'll forget it. You'll never think they ever like one another at all. This is going to be one of the fights of the year. No doubt about it. My man within 8 or 9 rounds.
Gary Mason, all the time you're around, the same rings as Cook. He's now age 32. Did you ever see big titles inside James Cook?
I've always seen Cook as an opponent-like person, but now he's a champion. He's done a lot now, of late, and he's not going to give anything away.
You like that uppercut punch of his?
Well, we're going to have to watch for the uppercut from Cook and the overhand right from Kaylor.
Okay, Gary.
Keep your eyes on it.
Yeah. Keep your eyes on it, folks. Big fight time. Let's join our commentators, Glenn McCrory, and first, Ian Dark for Kaylor against Simpson.
Well, this should be some fight. Certainly, Kaylor Simpson was a pretty good fight back in the mid-80s. It's Kaylor Cook, of course, tonight. Cook. And there is Mark Kaylor coming out for the 48th time and for his 6th title fight tonight. A British and a Commonwealth champion at middleweight, but never, so far, a European champion. He's failed in 4 European title attempts at 3 different weights, Kaylor. But I've watched this fellow right the way through his career, right back to the days of 1980 when he was fresh out of the Olympics and became a professional. And believe me, he's always been tremendous value for money, and that's why he's had such a massive following in East London. High-profile career. Kaylor's been a star, but his star has been on the wane of late, it has to be said. And here, he needs to resurrect things. If he loses this one, it just might be the end of the road for him. Coming out to the Bubbles tune, which accompanies the West Ham football team. Of course, they got promoted to the first division. That's where Kaylor is looking to get back to himself, boxing's first division. Now, here comes Cook, Harry Holland, Brian Lawrence ahead of him. Cook, in complete contrast to Kaylor, has had a very low-profile career, just a journeyman, it was thought, an opponent. But suddenly, rather in the fashion of Dennis Andres, things have started to blossom for him late on. He went away to win a British title in Belfast against Sam Storey. He went away again to Paris to beat the highly respected Pierre Frank Winterstein, the French gypsy, knocking him out with that tremendous shot you saw in the 12th round, the right uppercut. Have to watch that shot tonight. And here's Cook on his way now to make the first defence of the European Super Middleweight Championship and a world title opportunity beckoning for the winner. How does he look to you, Glenn?
He looks very well. He looks well prepared, psyched up. It should be a fabulous fight.
All the makings that this one has got the ingredients to provide something special. We can't guarantee it, you never can. But Kaylor fights have often been very, very entertaining. Roll blood and guts up. You remember the fight with Roy Gums. Anyone who was there would never forget it. The fight with Errol Christie as well. The Simpson fight. He really has been in some great battles, Kaylor, but how much is there left? That's one of the questions that will be answered tonight. Kaylor in the claret and blue that he's worn throughout his career, the claret and blue, of course, of West Ham.
I think what makes it appear to be going to be a very good fight is the fact that both these guys are very, very determined and both very gritty. So we know we're going to get both guys trying the very, very best, which has all the means of being a great fight.
Well, they're just putting the gloves on in the ring here. Kaylor still trained by Jimmy Tibbs. He was, of course, managed by Terry Lawless. Now, officially, he manages himself. He still works in the Terry Lawless gym, but he's self-managed officially. Jimmy Tibbs, though, is the trainer. Just gloving them up here. Kaylor, an ABA champion and an Olympic quarter finalist as an amateur. And Cook here, one of the, well, only two men who hold a victory over Michael Watson.
That's right. At different times in his career, a lot of people said he was a journeyman. He has proven that he is a quality fighter.
Brian Lawrence there on the right of the picture, Harry Holland on the left. Very tense, nervy moments these for the fighters. They'll have warmed up in the dressing room, and really they just can't wait to get this started. And now we have all these preliminaries. They're not as protracted as you get in, say, a big fight in Las Vegas, but the time is being spun out.
This
How
is
will the fighters
the,
feel like this?
This is the, it's
tremendous support here for Kaylor, as always, in East London.
And in the red corner from Peckham, wearing the black trunks, the super middleweight champion of Europe, James Cook.
The reception for Cook in sharp contrast.
At the weigh-in at 1 o'clock today, Kaylor scaled 11 stone 13 pounds, Cook 11 stone 12 pounds. Your timekeeper for this contest, Mr. Tommy Rice.
So all the preliminaries are just about over. The now traditional eyeball-to-eyeball confrontation as they get the final instructions from referee Mickey Van, who will score the fight, along with two judges, Adrian Morgan of Wales, Billy Rafferty of Scotland. Referee and two judges to score it. 12 rounds for the European Super Middleweight Championship. Mark Kaylor, who seems to have been around in London about as long as the mousetrap to me, and the claret and blue, James Cook, defending the title in the black trunks. Kaylor is a real pressure fighter. You see him coming forward, forward all the time, caught there by the left of Cook on the way in.
Kaylor's come straight out to have a bit of a war, straight into it. And he's just got to be a little bit careful that he doesn't get caught when he's called.
Clipped with another right there by Cook. But Kaylor is one of those fighters who's hardly taken a backward step throughout his career. No counter-puncher he. Cook snapping out his jab. He's on a bit of a roll, Cook. His confidence will have been boosted tremendously by having won those two titles, though he now has relinquished the British Championship, just holding on to the European and hoping, maybe, for a shot at the Worlds as well. But this big, big obstacle, and it's a voluntary defence here by Cook. He's gambling a little bit.
I think that might show something towards Cook's confidence, that he's took this fight straight away. He obviously felt very, very confident winning the European title and doing it in such good fashion.
There's a nice punches close in by Cook. Short little lift and a right uppercut. Now that's the punch you have to watch. And I think just for a moment, as one of those landed, Kaylor's legs just did stiffen. But look at him. He wants to go to war with Cook here.
It certainly did. Kaylor's legs did a little bump they made then, just as that uppercut landed.
He's landed with four of them already. Four right uppercuts, Cook. Classy punch. These two have sparred dozens of rounds together. And Cook was just brought in as the opponent, as it were, for those sparring sessions when Kaylor was preparing for his big fights back in the middle of the 80s. Caught by a right this time. Impressive start from the champion.
This is the sort of start that makes it look that it's not going to go 12 rounds. Obviously, they know each other, so there's no real feeling out. They've done a lot of sparring together, so they're straight into action.
Now, I don't think there's any real animosity or anything like that between these two. They were mates in the past, and Cook is a hard man to hate. He's a very amiable fellow. But that friendship will be forgotten for the next three quarters of an hour or so.
I think they obviously both respect each other as good, solid pros.
Coming up then to the closing seconds of this first round. It's been a pretty good first round for Cook. He looks nice and confident, in control. Kaylor hasn't done too much himself. And the first round to Cook. Remember, it's due to go 12 here.
This new Volvo 940 GL has a foldaway...
Kaylor just does a little graze by the side of his right eye and underneath. Nothing serious at the moment. He has been known to cut once or twice before. They're putting plenty of grease on his face. Action from round one. That good right from Cook there. And there were a few uppercuts as well. I think he will have won the first round on all three scorecards. Could be wrong, but that's the way it looked to us anyway. Second round, European super middleweight title, Kaylor in the claret and blue of West Ham. Cook, also a Londoner, defending the title. Good shots again there from Cook. Busy. Nice short punches that don't travel very far close in. Kaylor coming back with a left hook himself and still wanting to apply the pressure. Seems to want to lean on a lot close in and deny Cook leverage, Kaylor.
He's doing that, but he's also getting too close to get leverage to his own shot. And he's leaning over Cook and allowing Cook to come up with that good right uppercut.
In the past, I used to think sometimes Kaylor was a little underestimated as a boxer. He could sometimes work quite nicely behind his jab and then follow it in with a right. He's not certainly trying anything like that tonight. I don't think he's thrown a jab hardly so far.
Well, that's always been a thing with Kaylor's fighting. He likes a fight, and he can box, and he is quite a good boxer. But he likes to get in there, and he likes to mix it. And sometimes that's been good for him. Sometimes it's been his undoing.
One of the big questions here is how ring-worn, how shot-worn has Kaylor become? He's 2 years younger, but he's had twice as many fights as Cook. So in boxing terms, Cook is a younger, fresher man.
He looks the fresher at the minute. Kaylor seems to be getting caught with some punches, and he does seem to be sagging a little bit. He looks as if he has a cut now on his left eye.
Cut by the side of the left eye for Kaylor. And he's been caught by those rope uppercuts, and he's been elbowed around inside the clinch. He's getting with a few body shots of his own and working away with a couple of uppercuts himself. But the sharper, more impressive work has come from Cook so far. And that blood starts to flow a little thicker by the left eye. Two of them really trading punches here close in. And I told you earlier that Kaylor went for blood and guts thrillers, and that's what we're getting.
Well, absolute thriller at the moment. Fabulous fight. Cook just seems to have the better rhythm in there. He's working away with hooks and uppercuts a little better.
Kaylor there landed with one of his best shots, a right over the top. Good punch from him. Throwback to his earlier career when he was on the way up and world ranked as a middleweight. Cook is going to have to work for this, but he knows that. He'll have known it in the build-up, because Kaylor's very career is on the line here. He'll give it everything. Good counter-punching off the ropes there by Cook, though. Excellent work from him. Turning Kaylor as well. That was an impressive burst from Cook, who looks much improved and quite polished here. Kaylor is applying tremendous pressure, leaning on close in. He wants it to make it a close quarter brawl all the way through, but he's got the cut as well. And for me in that second round, Cook again did the more impressive work and probably took round two as well. What did you think, Glenn?
I think he did. He's getting away. He's getting the closer, the best shots in close. He's coming up with some good work on the retreat. Although Kaylor is leaning into him, pushing forward, Cook's coming back with a better counters, nice uppercuts, nice hooks. And at one or two stages, Kaylor did seem to be staggered a little bit.
Well, they're working on that cut by the left eye. Here's James Cook, unmarked. He's started off very well here. There he is from Peckham. 24 fights, 16 wins and 8 defeats. A lot of those defeats have come away from home. He was on the road a lot, taking fights for money. But now he's in a bigger league. And he suddenly is the man who's being groomed for stardom, albeit at the age of 32. Lives in Hackney with his wife and four children. And as his manager, Harry Holland, says, you won't catch him down the disco. Super dedicated, fanatical trainer. Little delay to the start of the round. Mickey Van, the referee, wants some blood or grease, I think it is. They've got too much grease by that eye, and Jimmy Tipps there is being ordered to wipe some of it away. Start of the third round. And we've had plenty of action in the first two already. Cook, the champion, the European champion in the black trunks.
This sort of fighting that they're doing in the minute seems just to suit Cook a little better at this moment. He's getting the better shots off. He's getting the nice hooks, nice uppercuts. I think Kaylor could do a step back and get a little bit more leverage into his jab and his right hand.
Kaylor leaning all the time, and Mickey Van there also, or almost took a right hand from Cook there. Brave man to step in as the punches were flying. Kaylor's tactics, he wants to turn it into a close quarter brawl, ramming home a good left to the body there. Kaylor just looking to wear Cook down, erode away the championship belt from him. But Cook's having none of it. Two chopping little right hands and the uppercut as well. Back comes Kaylor with the left hook. It's not a pretty sight, the tactics of Kaylor here, but he's hoping it'll pay off in the long run. He will have trained, I would think, very, very hard for this one. Because as I've said before, if he loses it, there might not be very many places to go.
From sparring with Cook that much, maybe Kaylor knows that he maybe thinks that Cook will wilt a little bit if he sets the pace. That seems to be what he's doing. Whether that'll work, I'm not sure.
Two of them both still pretty busy though, working inside. Kaylor, of course, veteran of four previous European title attempts. He landed with a right there, and he's got Cook on the ropes. Was a good left hook, good shots here. Look at the two of them trading. What a fight this is turning out to be.
Kaylor got some of his best success there.
Good little right in there inside, and what a nice uppercut again. Very impressive shot that is from Cook. Watch the heads, says referee Mickey Van. I have to watch that with Kaylor. Just cut a little bit about one of his eyes. But this, so far, is fast and very grueling. Last 20 seconds or so of the third round. Every punch Kaylor lands has been cheered to the echo by his West Ham supporters in this crowd. £75 they paid for their ringside seats as well tonight. There it is, great third round here, and a great fight. Still putting some grease by that cut left eye of Kaylor. 47 fights, 40 wins, 6 defeats and a draw in an 11-year career for Mark Kaylor. Fourth round. Kaylor probably had his best round so far in the third, and he keeps up the pressure. Cook, though, coming back with his combinations, a little right to the head from him as well. Cook, 32 years of age, no spring chicken himself. And that's a good right from him over the top and the uppercut as well. Kaylor had to take those.
Both men are landing with fabulous shots. The fight's going one way and then the other. At the end of that round, Kaylor just seemed to get his range and catch Cook with a good right hand, left hook. And then now Cook started off very good himself.
You get the feeling that there's more variety about Cook's work. He looks the better boxer of the two, doesn't he, by quite some distance.
When he lets his shots go, he lets them go with both hands, and they flow from right to left, and it doesn't give Kaylor a chance to really, get steady. He works a lot better inside. Kaylor has got to rely on that long right hand and the left hook.
That's a good right again from Cook. Nice repertoire he's got. Short little punches when they work in close, and that lovely uppercut he's developed. Kaylor pressuring him all the time, leaning on, trying to wear him down. That cut's no worse by the left eye. That's the view you'd get if you were, almost like referee Mickey Van. And a good right again over the top, and then another right cross again from Cook. Twice he landed with those. Kaylor, in truth, has never been the most elusive of fighters. Oh, that was a fair right, though. Jolting right from Kaylor. Cook rather walked onto that. Kaylor keep up this pressure in his 48th fight? Will the pace he set end up defeating him?
You need a great deal of conditioning to fight like this for 12 rounds because it's a very physical fight. There's lots of good punches going in and also lots of pushing and shoving and pulling, and that takes an awful lot out of you to do that for a few rounds. But it's certainly the thriller that everybody expected.
Kaylor hardly knows how to be in a boring fight. There's thrillers with the likes of Tony Simpson and Harold Graham, Tom Collins when he got beaten, the European light heavyweight title, old-fashioned look between them at the end of the fourth round. Welcome back, Sky Sports live from the York Hall in Bethnal Green, and what's proving to be a superb fight here for the European super middleweight title. There's that right from Kaylor in the last round. That was one of his best shots so far. Cook rather walked onto it. Jimmy Tibbs there, urging his man on, motivating him. Fifth round, and these European title fights go 12. I have Cook ahead so far, but the issue is, of course, by no means decided. There's the colour check for you, Cook in the black trunks.
It'll be very interesting to see how the judges score this fight because it's constantly swaying from one man to the other. I have Cook ahead, but it's a fabulous fight.
That's a lovely right over the top by Cook. That's just a slip by Kaylor. It won't be counted as a knockdown, it certainly was, and he just lost his balance. Bit of blood coming from the mouth as well of Kaylor. They were a bit worried about that between the rounds. But this man just digs deeper and deeper and deeper into his wells of courage. And that's why the crowds have loved him over the last decade.
Well, it's great to see a fighter who always gives value for money. You know, people respect that. And Kaylor always did. Win or lose, it was always a great fight he was in.
Yeah, the fight with Errol Christie when they were both on the floor twice before Kaylor won it would go down, I think, in anybody's top five British fights of the 1980s.
I think that fight was that tough that really it stopped Errol Christie becoming a great fighter because it was just such a tough fight for him. He never recovered from that.
Kaylor scoring significantly with a couple of rights, notably the uppercut, and Cook there on the ropes and taking a few. Kaylor is still there, still pitching. What a story it would be if he could lift this European title. Everybody thought it was all over for him when he went off to America to try and rebuild his career after the defeat by Tom Collins in 1988 for the light heavyweight title. We thought we'd seen the last of him, but back he's come. And it would be quite a comeback if he was to win here. Cook just breathing now a little more heavily. He's been made to work very, very hard. Surely they can't keep up this relentless pace for 12 rounds.
It just shows their remarkable conditioning. They must have worked very, very hard for this fight.
Two of them just, I think, happy there to take a little three-second breather. Back they get to work though, and all those good punches there. Cook putting them together well, lefts and rights to the head. Last few seconds coming up then of the fifth round. Tremendous scrap for this European title, and more of it still to come here live on Sky Sports. York Hall, Bethnal Green. This is Mark Kaylor, 30 years of age now, in his fifth European title attempt. And they've done a very, very good job indeed in the corner on that left eye. The blood is not flowing at all, and happily, I don't think we're going to get a stoppage on that particular cut unless it opens up badly again. Out they come for the sixth round. James Cook, the European super middleweight champion at 12 stone in the black shorts here, up against Mark Kaylor. star of British boxing for the last 10 or 11 years. Looking to bring back the good times.
Cook seems to be having the best of the work at long range as well. He was getting the better punches off close in, and he also seems to be teeing Kaylor off a little bit at long range as well.
In Kaylor's first attempt to lift this title against Mario Galvano, he came very close. It was a good right from Cook in there. In fact, it was a disputed decision, and Galvano's gone on to become WBC champion, so that's the way it goes in boxing. Kaylor scoring with the jab that time. Good punches again from Cook. The fanatical training he does paying off here. He's landing with some good shots in this round. Really putting the punches together well. Not so much coming back from Kaylor. And he looked a bit unsteady on his feet there. He was rocked. His knees buckled by that right. And you wonder if Kaylor is coming towards the end of his tether.
He certainly looked hurt there. Cook got through with several good punches. Right at the end of it, he just wobbled a bit.
15 punches may be unanswered. Somebody throws a bit of paper out of vision into the ring there. For what reason, I couldn't begin to describe. Oh, Cook here is starting here to take control in a fairly significant way in the sixth round. Kaylor comes back again. I don't know where he finds it from sometimes.
He has such brilliant determination. He's when he looks so under pressure is when he comes back so good. He's a very determined boy.
But he's beginning to tire, Kaylor. And he's beginning to tire, perhaps, significantly. This sixth round may just go down as the start of the end for him, or will Kaylor prove us all wrong? Cook really has put together some very, very good work, like that. And then a right. Kaylor is covering up, and the towel has been put in. They've thrown in the towel. Mickey Van is trying to pull Kaylor off the corner. Have thrown in the towel. You're not officially allowed to do that. The referee should stop the fight. Does Kaylor want to be stopped? We have some controversy here, but Jimmy Tibbs threw in the towel. That was surrender. What it means is that James Cook is still the European super middleweight champion, and presumably after what was a very impressive performance, a world title opportunity beckons for him at 32. It's a British boxing fairy tale, this one. If you told somebody 3 years ago that James Cook would be in a world title fight, they'd have laughed in your face. For Kaylor, it may be the end of the line. He really did try everything he knew here, but what he knew at the age of 30 and in his 48th fight wasn't quite enough for this resurgent James Cook. And you take your hat off to him. There's Kaylor. Sad sight. But I think the decision from the corner, Glenn, was they didn't want to see him get badly hurt.
I think it was a good decision. Kaylor wasn't very happy with it, but you know, that's because he's such a game guy. But I think it was a good decision. The corner obviously looking out for him. I can't say anything bad against it.
So James Cook, there is Terry Lawless, the old manager of Kaylor, coming over for a sympathetic word. I wonder if he realizes it just might be the last we see of Kaylor in the ring.
After 2 minutes 40 seconds of the sixth round, the referee has accepted Mark Kaylor's retirement. The winner and undefeated super middleweight champion of Europe, James Cook.
Well done, James Cook. This is a story really like that Dennis Andrews story, a man who lost plenty, but whose dedication in the end has paid off. And every penny he earns, I say good luck to him, and I hope there are plenty more. As for Kaylor, he has been one of the great value for money fighters.
Supervisor to present the championship belt to James Cook.
Ray Clark there, the former secretary of the British Boxing Board of Control. Simon Block as well from the board, and they're putting that European belt back around Cook's waist, and it's a sweet moment for him. Harry Holland whispers words of encouragement in his ears. And Harry Holland, give him credit, because since he went to Harry Holland, Cook's career has been turned around. There's poor Mark Kaylor. Mickey Duff, words of consolation. What a sad sight that is. But this fellow has no need to feel any sadness. Gary Richardson is going to have a word with him. Let's have a word, Gary,
Mark,
with Mark Kaylor.
Commiserations. You're obviously very upset the way it ended.
We've gone on forever.
Mark, can you talk about it at the moment?
Because I'm upset.
OK, let's just have a word with Jimmy Tibbs. Jimmy, I think you obviously did that for Mark's own good there, ending it when you did.
Well, yeah, getting caught a few times, and I thought it was the right time to pull him out. I was going to give him one round, I was going to talk to him at the end of the round, but for another half a minute, it didn't make that much difference.
And just one word, I know it's obviously a difficult time to ask you. What would you see for Mark's future now? Possibly retirement?
We'll talk about that later on.
OK, thank you very much indeed.
So, well, they'll think about it. They've got to have time to think about that. But I'm afraid we now have a bit of argy-bargy going on behind us here with one or two fans. And this is the kind of scene we definitely don't need. And I think it's just a minority, and it's quickly been brought under control. And I'm glad to hear that. I think one or two of the Kaylor fans who may have had just a little bit too much to drink, just causing a bit of a scuffle behind us. Nothing too much to worry about, I'm glad to say. Well, in a moment, we'll try to get a word with the champion, James Cook. So we're having all sorts of dramas here. We do not need that kind of silliness. I must say, boxing crowds are normally very, very well behaved. That was just a little scuffle and nothing more than that. Well, if we go up into the ring, I think we can have a word with the European super middleweight champion, still the champion, James Cook. He's talking now to Gary
James,
Richardson.
Many congratulations indeed. That was some performance by you.
Thank you. Well, it's some performance by me for the last four fights. You know, I just decided I refuse to get beat by nobody at all, because a lot of guys beat me and they shouldn't beat me, you know. And when me and my trainer sit down and talk, you know, we just decided to get ourselves together, and he keep telling me I must believe in myself, Giant Harry. Harry said, believe in myself. And I just had to believe in myself and put it together, you know?
A word about Mark Kaylor. It was a brave, brave performance
by
him.
Believe me, people were saying to me that Mark Kaylor is gone. He's not the same Mark Kaylor. But I sparred with Mark Kaylor probably 5-6 years ago, and I predicted each time Mark Kaylor was going to beat Harold Christy Rygums and a couple of Americans. He did. I knew he was brave. Believe me, he's one of the bravest men in boxing. And I knew tonight all I have to do was to stay with Mark, keep him at bay. The distance was no problem, the stamina was no problem. All I knew tonight was just keep him at bay, stay with him, and hit him when I want, you know?
Why suddenly at this stage in your career are things suddenly going so right for you?
Management and basically faith in my trainer, believe me, you know, and management, you know, sit down with the management, and the first time we have sort of something worked together. You know, he would take step at a time. Before, it was just James to fight in America, well, not in America, Paris, France, Germany, places like that. Didn't know what the opponent was like. It was an unlucky loss, but I never complain, I never moan, you know?
Well, let's have a word with your manager, Harry Holland. I suppose he's almost a slightly younger version of Dennis Andrews, isn't he?
That's right, Gary. That's Dennis Andrews Mark II, except for uses James Cook Mark I. Believe me, Gary, you know, I've always had faith in the fella. He's always been a good fighter. I watched him from a kid. We're going after the world title now. Hopefully Van Horn we're looking at. We're talking to Cordova's people sometime probably in October, we hope, if things go right. But I'm going to pull out all the stops for him.
Which one would you actually prefer? We saw Darren Van Horn on Sky Sports a couple of weeks ago. He looked a good performer.
Van Horn was... We're not going to hang around. We're going after a world title.
And just a word on Mark Kaylor. He's been a great ambassador for British boxing. Would you feel now that's possibly the end of his career tonight?
Yes, I think Mark has been an absolute ambassador for the sport, as you say. He's been a credit to the game. But I think Mark's got nothing else to prove. He went out the same way that he boxed before. He's a fantastic sportsman, and we give Mark Kaylor all the best. And we wish him all the best. If he does to decide, whatever he does, if he does retire, we wish him all the best.
I must just ask you one other thing as a promoter of this fight, Harry. We've seen a good fight in the ring, but there were very, very ugly scenes outside of the ring.
It's absolutely disgusting, Gary. Absolutely disgusting. None of us like that. This is about the general art. You just see two fellas there, fought their hearts out, and love one another after. This is rubbish. We don't want this in a game. We don't want those people to come to support us. I'm sorry.
I think it's something that perhaps the British Boxing Board of Control might take up with you as a promoter. Any comment on that?
No, only we had enough staff here, as you said. see now it's quieting down as quickly as possible. You could do it. I don't think too many people hurt too much, thank Christ. But as I said before, we don't, you know, winners worldwide promotions and everyone, we don't incise that sort of thing at all.
Okay, Harry, thank you very much
thank
indeed,
very
and
much
congratulations to James once more.
Thank you, guys.
So, James Cook. Tremendous performance from him. He really did put the punches together well. Kaylor by the sixth round had taken rather too much now. I think we can have a look back on the sixth round, Glenn, here. And by this stage, Kaylor was starting to wilt. His legs buckled from one of these punches. And Cook really did put together a very impressive array indeed. There you are, Kaylor sagging back against the ropes there, the right over the top. He slipped a couple, and that's where the towel came in. You could see it coming in.
And he was under pressure. He was taking some good shots. I thought that was a good act by the corner. You know, Kaylor wasn't going to win. Cook was beating him to everything. He was beating him to the shots inside, beating him at distance. And it was a good decision. A good right hand there from Cook.
And it rather had the feel about it of a sort of predestined decision by the corner, that they felt as if Kaylor was going to take too much in this fight. They were going to pull him out of it. They didn't want him going away with his half damage.
That's right. They didn't want to see him, you know, take any kind. He's had a long career, 47 fights, and at the end of it, the last thing you want is to see him get really hurt. And they did it was a good decision. And Cook fought fabulous, and it looks like it'll be a great fight if he fights Van Horn, because that would give him a great chance.
Yeah, Cook against Van Horn, that would be a very good fight. As for Kaylor, I think those little tearful scenes as he was trying to explain what happened to Gary there, and the words just wouldn't come. Well, one of the saddest sights I've seen, and possibly the end of an 11-year career where, well, things didn't always go superbly for Mark Kaylor, but what entertainment he gave us, and maybe there's more entertainment to come from this fellow, James Cook.